Hey guys, Bormac here, for a new game. Why? Because I said so. This is one I actually found on Kongregate way back when. It was a demo, and I had fun with it, I played it all the way through, and then I forgot about it until today. I actually had to scrounge around for like an hour to find this thing's website. I liked the game a lot back then, so I went ahead and bought it. Creeper World. My goodness, look at all these levels. So we're just going to be doing the intro here. Year 13271, humankind had colonized thousands of worlds. Found none their equal as they spread into a fantastic and bountiful empire. The height of their greatness, they walked amongst the stars as though they were gods. But gods they were not. It fell from the sky without purpose or reason. 50 worlds fell on the first day. 500 billion lives were lost. World after world fell as man was routed from existence. Nothing could stop what we come to call the Creeper. It wanted nothing. It could not be reasoned with. It seemed as though its only purpose was to undo all that man had done. There's a lot of dead people. But all was not yet lost. Last survivors of humanity had gathered on a world called Hope. Assembled by the visions of a crazed old man, humankind marks its final hours. A great city has been built to house the 50,000 that survive. It will journey from world to world, never staying longer than it must. Guided by the path set by the old man, humanity's final journey has begun.
Boop.
Follow my instructions precisely. Time is critical. The city is at the center of your console. She is almost ready to launch. Click the collector button in the command bar. There's an arrow showing that button.
Boop.
Now build it where I have indicated.
Boop.
Click the cancel button at exit build mode.
Boop.
Collectors produce energy. Each collector produces energy proportional to the green area around it. Always try to position collectors so they create the greatest total green area with the fewest collectors. Structures must be connected to Odin City to be operational. The collector you just built produces not only energy, but also connects a group of existing collectors to Odin City. Also some unfinished collectors of the east of Odin City. Since they are now connected to the city, they can be finished. Odin City will produce and deliver construction packets to these collectors. That's what it's doing right there. They indicate that we have only minutes before the first wave of Creeper arrives. We must act fast. Build a relay where I have indicated.
Boop.
Boop. Relays create long-range connections, but only with other relays. They're useful for spanning valleys or creating more direct paths to your base. As the relays are complete, three newly connected blasters will start to charge. These blasters were built earlier and have not yet fully armed. Let's wait for the blasters to charge. There's one additional blaster to the north of Odin City. Click it now. Now, where I've indicated, move the blaster. A key strategy when defending against creepers is to move and position your weapons wisely. Creeper has arrived. This is it, Commander. So our blasters hold out the creeper just long enough for us to open drift and get Odin City out of danger. We need to power three rift totems in order to activate the rift. These three totems are in the upper right corner of the map. Click Odin City and fire to the location I'll indicate. Once there, the city will supply rift packets to the totems. Once all three totems are charged, we activate the rift. Yeah, it's such a weird concept. So we're not fighting units, we're fighting like this tidal wave of goo. And it just doesn't stop. Oh, we lost the structure. See, we're up on a plateau, though. So it's gotta build up before it can wash over us. Rift active! Let's GTFO! Sorry, defenses. I'll miss you. Achievement awarded. Hope. And, stuff. Graphs. Ta-da. I don't care. Let's go. Taurus. Rift complete. We have rifted to the next world, and now that our journey has begun, our goal is to leave each world as quickly as possible. On each world we visit, the creeper will be hunting us. It has destroyed thousands of worlds and won't hesitate to destroy the few of us that remain. Commander, I have some bad news. First rift jumped as a race to our data banks. We've lost valuable nanoschematics. As we visit new worlds, we'll have to collect whatever technology we find to rebuild our data banks. Scatters indicate there is some small good news to report. There is a nanoschematic for building relays at the bottom of your console. Yeah, right there. You need to collect this tech and then activate the rift totems. I recommend building one or two blasters and using them to push back the creeper that is headed this way from the south. Your blasters forward slowly, a small jump at a time. Each time you jump, build collectors behind the blasters to extend their network. Once you get the nano schematic connected to our network, you'll be able to build relays again. Build relays, you can charge totems. This is not good. That'll have to do, I guess. Aren't built yet. Come on, city. They're almost built. Now, what are you doing? Let's build a collector right there. Stuff piling up here. This will go a lot faster once we get more of these collectors online. It's always slow at the beginning. Build ammo. Lots of building going on. Once we get that one connected or that one. Alright, there's the collector. You go right there. You go there. Let's just completely cover this hillside. To do is get down to this guy, which, you know, is easier said than done. There you go. There and give him back up. Then we'll have the relays finally. This stuff's building up way too high. You go away, we don't need you. You. destroy. Aha! Fool! Okay, right here. To there. This is as best as I can do right now. Get those relays up is what we need. Collection 3.2, depletion 3. Just wear it down there, guys. That's all you need to do. That'll go a little better once that relay is done. Don't worry, we'll get out of here in a minute. I know it's not the most action-y game, but it does get kind of strategic later, and I'm, you know, like I said, I'm fond of it. So I'll play it. You don't have to watch it if you don't want to. I'm sorry. I just wanted to play something good after friggin' Crime Life today. That game gave me a migraine. I need to push this stuff back. Got this guy cornered. Go over here. You over here. Don't worry, it'll be powered in a second. There we go. And the rift is active! Whoosh! See ya! I like how it can keep powering things even though it's flying away. Oh! Sorry, guys. Sucks to be you. Whoop-de-doo. Don't care. How long have I been playing? Let's go for one more. Oh man, gave us coordinates for each of these worlds. The gods only know how he got them. He's the only reason we survived long enough to build over the city in the first place, so we owe him the benefit of the doubt. Plus, what other choice do we have, really? There is a narrow schematic for energy storage on this world. Build out a base and collect it. And collect this as a first order of business. Energy storage will allow you to construct storage pods that will buffer the energy our collectors produce. This can be useful when you need to build or arm lots of things at the same time. Mindful of the energy consumption at all times. Watch the red starvation indicator in the lower right. Blah, 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 words. Okie dokie, then. Need to make sure everything's connected here. There we go. We don't have to worry too much in these early levels because the creep is always further back, and it's not threatening us directly, but later on it'll be right on our frickin' doorstep immediately. For now, we can just collect our energy. We are using way more than we're making, though. That should work. Can build turrets up here. We won't need very many turrets in the back, since it's got to come through this valley. Turrets right here would work splendidly. Let's just make sure we're collecting maximum energy. So might want to put one right on this. Alright. Oops. You go away now. There we go. And storage, 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 storage. Gotcha. How far along is my little span the gap thing here? Stuff go. Whee! Not sure how many levels high we are right now. It's kind of difficult to tell with a top-down, but I think it's just one. Which means this stuff doesn't... We'll have to fill all this before it can threaten us, so we're okay so far. Might wanna... a secondary route over, though. Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. Which is why I started the route over. Both, but we'll need to push this stuff way back if we're gonna get that one in the middle. And now we're just trying to buy some time here. Provide additional buffer when building. Yep. Let's build another one right here. One up here. One right there. Alright, turrets back online. Get some more storage. Yeah, this stuff can go pretty fast once you've got some energy storage. As you can see, start, yep, green dots. It's built, charging that one now. Alright, drop that there, drop that there, drop that there. Collect as much energy as we possibly can. Might be able to squeeze one in down here. It hasn't developed that far yet. Just a guess, though. Looks like we're fine. I just need to get those three turrets up, and then 8 of these turrets combined should be enough to push it back so we can build right there. Let's expedite things a little bit, though, by building a couple there, too. Creep is creeping. I might have underestimated how much creep 5 nodes could put out. Let's add a couple more turrets. Oops, didn't mean to build that. Get out of here. There we go. Alright, hey, we actually pushed it back. Perfect. You guys can go up here. It's not really important. Beacon will be charged before that relay is built. But they won't run out of ammo before that, though. Yep, there's the beacon. Woohoo! Goodbye, defense, I'll miss you. Yay! My goodness. Do not care. Well, I think I'm going to end it here. It's been 20 minutes or so. If you guys are into this, I can play some more. I mean, I'm going to play it either way. But if you guys want to watch me play it... Like I said, it does get more action-y. This was sort of the tutorial bits. We're still learning in these first... What is this? 5? And then it starts getting more hectic as we get to the question mark and beyond. But, you know, I mean, it's up to you. Let me know, guys. I'll talk to you all later, alright? Bye-bye for now.